Ladies and gentlemen, I am Lieutenant Colonel Sam Campbell, your master of ceremonies, and it is my pleasure to welcome you here today to the retirement ceremony honoring the distinguished service of Brigadier General Larry L. Henry. The presiding official for today's ceremony is Major General Michael Turley, Utah National Guard Adjutant General. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the arrival of the official party, presentation of the colors, and the singing of the national anthem, followed by the invitation. Members of our official party are the Adjutant General of the Utah National Guard, Major General Michael Turley, and Brigadier General Larry L. Henry. The Color Guard today is provided by 19th Special Forces Group. Color Guard, present. We will now receive the invocation by Pastor Danny Brooks of the Gospel Local Church.
Let's pray. Our God and Father, we thank you for this occasion that brings us together, which reminds us not only of the blessing of our armed forces, but also the freedom of these United States of America. We thank you for this nation and for your providential care over us through the centuries, as you have sustained us through conflicts, both international and civil, protected us and prospered us. We ask that in this retirement ceremony for General Henry, that you would allow these moments, that you would hallow these moments with your presence. Thank you for the Henry family. Thank you for these years of service, of sacrifice, of discipline, expertise, wisdom, and care. Thank you for his investment in the leadership and training of so many others. Would you raise up a new generation of strong, wise leaders with the moral character to lead our nation's forces. Thank you for Danita and her sacrifice of time with her husband, of his presence through the years of his deployments, for the days of parenting the best she could without him nearby, even of those lonely days that she gave for us. Bless the Henrys richly on this day and all the days that are yet to come as they reflect on these many years of service, on the honor achieved and the friendships made, the missions accomplished, and the people who have been blessed. And through this celebration this afternoon, renew our sense of privilege and purpose as citizens of this great nation. Move us to commit ourselves afresh to the cause of freedom, both here in the United States and around the world. And to that end, let this commitment be molded by our military and empowered by your grace. And above all, we pray that you would give each of us eyes that see beyond this world, this lifetime, eyes of the heart and soul that grasp the eternal significance of each day, the value of each person created in your image, and the gift of eternal life offered to us in your Son, Jesus the Christ. It is in your precious name that we pray these things. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Brooks. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Today we are privileged to have with us, in addition to General Turley, the Assistant Adjutant General, Army Brigadier General Tyler Smith, 19th Special Forces Group Commander Colonel Peters, Chief Warrant Officer 5 Searcy, and the Land Component Command Sergeant Major Baum. In addition to all the other chiefs, retired general officers, and CSMs out there, honorary colonels, local civilian leaders, the men and women of the Utah National Guard, and thank you all who have taken the time to share this special occasion. Today we give special recognition to Brigadier General Henry. General Henry is closing out a long and dedicated career of military service. We are privileged to have with us today some of General Henry's family and friends. General Henry, would you care to stand and say?
Thanks for coming today. My wife, of course, Danita, here in the front row. Eric, his wife, Madeline. Maddie's parents, Steve and Heidi Clark. Our pastor, Danny and Kristen Brooks from Gospel Church. My roommate from the Special Forces Qualification Course, Bob Annette, flew in from Vermont. The Lee family, Jaquita and Tanner. Rob couldn't be here today, and Hunter is down at Fort Bliss, Texas. Her mom and dad, the Birches. Our former neighbors, Greg and Julie Thompson. The representatives of the SFA are here. Jennifer and Sagan. Matt Parker's here. I saw him somewhere. The Dents. Some other folks from our church, Gospel Church. Randy, Diane, Matt. Is Noah here? Noah's not here. And then our caterers are also from our church, Jocelyn and Katie Vinicky. Did I miss somebody? Andy and Hank Pelletier are in the back there.
Thank you, sir, and a warm welcome to the family and friends joining us, and those joining us on the Utah National Guard Facebook page for those who were not able to make it. At this time, the organization would like to present a token of our appreciation to Mrs. Henry. These flowers are presented to Mrs. Henry by Staff Sergeant Ferguson. To the spouse does not wear a uniform, yet they serve their country too. They do not acquire nor wear ribbons. Show them where they have been, yet they go. They did not ask for the duty they performed, yet they unwaveringly perform it. They serve, yet they are not honored with trinkets or pieces of cloth showing their service. Thank you. We truly appreciate your contribution. Our spouses are always remembered, never forgotten. We now invite Major General Turley, General Henry, and his wife to come forward to the stage so that Major General Turley can present a certificate of appreciation to the Utah National Guard. The spouse certificate reads as follows. The certificate of appreciation is presented to Mrs. Danita V. Henry for the support you have given your husband during his honorable and distinguished service to the Utah National Guard and the United States of America. Your commitment to endure the hardships brought on by times of separation throughout his service enabled him to complete his commitment to protect our freedom and service to the citizens of our state and nation. Signed, Michael J. Turley, Major General, Adjutant General. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, Major General Turley will present General Henry his deployment awards. First, the Defense Superior Service Medal. To all uniformed personnel, attention to orders. Brigadier General Larry L. Henry, Army National Guard of the United States, distinguished himself by exceptionally superior service as the Chief of Staff, Kosovo Forces, Headquarters North Atlantic Treaty Organization, Operation Joint Guardian from June 2020 to July 2021. During this period, General Henry skillfully managed, facilitated, and directed the substantial and evolving activities of the multinational North Atlantic Treaty Organization headquarters in an ever-demanding and complex international environment. General Henry's dedication and leadership earned the respect and admiration of all that associated with him. His actions embodied the Kosovo Forces 25 motto, as one we progress. The distinctive accompaniments of General Henry reflect a great credit upon himself, the Army National Guard, and the United States and the Department of Defense. And now the award of the Austrian Military Medal of Recognition to all uniformed personnel, attention to orders. Brigadier General Larry Henry was Chief of Staff at HQK4 in Kosovo from June 2020 to June 2021, and was thus responsible for the leadership of his staff and for the work within the command group, COM-DCOM K4, particularly in very challenging COVID-19 situation, which also placed a great strain on the troops in the Kosovo theater of operations. The professional cooperation and unity in the HQK4 command group, which has also included Austrian DCOM K4 Brigadier General Gunter Schaff since October 2020, was also largely attributable to Brigadier General Henry's extraordinary commitment. Austrian contingent K4 thus requests the award of the Military Medal of Recognition to Brigadier General Larry Henry. General Henry, certificates and letters of appreciation. First, from the President of the United States. Second, from the Governor of the State of Utah. And now, from the Adjutant General of Utah, Major General Turley.
Haven't said my name enough yet.
At this time, we will pay tribute to Brigadier General Henry with the flag of the United States of America. We offer the appreciation of a grateful nation for the 34 years of contributions General Henry has made. Since the dawn of the 20th century, service personnel have proudly flown the flag in every major conflict on lands and skies around the world. It is their responsibility, our responsibility, to continue to protect and preserve the rights, privileges, and freedoms that we as Americans enjoy today. The United States flag represents who we are. It stands for the freedom we all share and the pride and patriotism we feel for our country. We cherish its legs as a beacon of hope to one and all. Long may it wave. General Henry, on behalf of many friends, including those who have made the ultimate and supreme sacrifice, we wish to present to you what is perhaps the military member's most honored and cherished possession, the United States National Flag, the flag which you have so proudly served, accepted, protected, guarded, and forever remember that the young men and women you have trained, guided, and inspired will follow in your footsteps and defend the people. We now ask Major General Turley to present General Henry's retirement certificate.
I told him this is the big one. This is the payday. This is the payday for Donita.
To all uniformed personnel, attention to orders. From the armed forces of the United States of America to all who shall see these presents, greeting. This is to certify that Brigadier General Larry O. Henry, having served faithfully and honorably, is retired from the United States Army on the 30th day of September, 2021. Signed, General James C. McConnell, United States Army Chief of Staff.
I'm going to keep it short because I want to preserve as much time for you, Larry, as possible. But I wrote down some things this morning when I was sitting in my office thinking about you. And retirements for me are bittersweet, especially when someone that I've worked with so much, as I have with Larry, over the years and since becoming the Adjutant General. Larry is an amazing person. He has sacrificed himself so much for this service, and we have just watched and witnessed this gratitude pour forth for him. But Donita, it is important to remember that really he couldn't have been here without you. We are going to miss having you in our family. We're going to miss having you around. But hopefully, as I talked to Larry before we walked out here, there will be excuses. There will be opportunities for you to come and share time with us. Larry, we're going to miss you. Again, that bittersweet part of retirement is we're happy, we're ecstatic with the success that you've had in your career. We do want you to go out and enjoy it, but we're going to miss your service. We're going to miss you. We're going to miss the camaraderie. But ultimately, retirement is about thanks and giving thanks to those things that are within our power and those things that are not within our power. Larry, for your direct service, thank you. You have done much. You have thrown yourself on that line over and over and over throughout these years. And I think all of us who wear the cloth understand what that means. From combat to training, Larry has been there. Donita, again, thank you for your undying support for him. To your children, those who are here, but those who are not here, thank you for those lost moments, those moments where your dad wasn't able to be there as part of your growing up. And the rest of your family and friends for all of the support that you've given to Larry throughout the years and to Donita. Because really, honestly, it becomes a community effort. Once someone goes forward to serve, then everybody else has to fall in on that position to try and support that. And then finally it gets down to the dog catcher, which has to make sure that things fall in place. I think this will mean something to you, Larry. It's to paraphrase a scripture, but well done, thou good and faithful servant. You have carried the load for us. But now it is time for you to serve both yourself as well as your family, to go out and do those things that you want to do, to go to the places that you want to go. And by the way, when I say you, I mean you and Donita, because I think she's going to tell you right now. And you need to savor the rewards that you've earned. I personally will miss you. I know the organization will miss you. While we'll miss your service, know that we know that you'll continue your service in other ways, whether that be through the community or through other things that you will do. We know that you will always be there because I think that's just who you are. Thank you again, Larry. Thank you again, Donita. Thank you to your family, to your friends, for your years and your sacrifices. Again, thank you.
So I'm pretty jealous of this. This is actually a really cool Gladius Award to you, Larry. And hopefully you'll keep this in a place where you'll always remember us. So, thank you.
We will now have anyone or organization who wishes to present a gift to General Henry to come forward, lining up to my left, your right, of the official party. Sorry, I'm trying to complicate this as much as possible.
So, Brigadier General Henry, on behalf of the logistics community, we wanted to present you this flag that you have defended and protected for so many years. And Sergeant Major, even though we haven't really worked closely together, Sergeant Major has, and he's mentioned to me many times how you have helped the logisticians under your command to do the job they need to do. So we are grateful for your support of them and the logistics community.
DC, myself, just want to appreciate all you've done for the Guard over your time. And one, for me at least, some shared love with our past century of parachute infantry regiments. A fun conversation. I've got to know you a little bit. I wish I've got to really know you more. But also, recent visit to Oregon. We've got to represent Utah up there for a promotion board with a bunch of other E9 cohort. And without having to bring his name up, it came up the great things he did in Kosovo. And the care for soldiers, and I can't help to be standing up here as an enlisted man, knowing the love and care he's given soldiers is not lost on him either. So a small token of our appreciation. Thank you, sir.
So, sir, we know you got something a little more significant when you left the 19th, but nonetheless, we didn't want you to go empty-handed today. So just another token of our appreciation. Obviously recognizing the building and your hand in that, but thanks for leaving that 19th much better than you found it.
Yes, sir, it's been great to interact with you over the last few years. I've interacted with you more from the GA perspective. But now I'm out here at Camp Williams, and you can't talk about Camp Williams without also talking about the 19th Special Forces Group and all the training that you guys do and the presence that you have here. So I want to give you the coin of UTC and appreciate your support and all the work we have with your soldiers here at the 19th.
On behalf of HRO and the family programs, we wanted to come out and say thanks so much, General Henry, for everything you've done. You've been an inspiring leader to me personally. I had the opportunity to serve under him in the great 19th, and so thank you for everything you've done for the organization and who you are.
Well, sir, now that we're a fellow retiree, knees. I'm going to break out of the mold and actually call you Larry. I don't think I could ever do it in public before, but I will now. I was Van Pearl Henry's Battalion CSM for 1st Battalion 19 Special Forces Group, and I know that you don't drink. However, while I was home in St. Petersburg a couple of years ago, I came across, because where I found another Special Forces legacy like yourself, is that is where they produce the First Soldier Bourbon Whiskey. So I picked up this bottle for you a few years ago. I've been kind of sitting on it, waiting for it, because I greatly appreciate you are the worthy, consummate professional when I found out, when I started working for you as a battalion commander. And I found out, as long as I was affiliated with the group, you were the consummate professional, but it wasn't just you, it was also Danita, and it wasn't just about professionalism, but you and Danita cared deeply for our soldiers and their families and all the things that we needed to do to build a team and take good care of each other. And just like this bottle, that will probably never be drank, I did have another one. I considered giving him the one that's on my shelf, but I didn't want to create an awkward situation where you had to say, this is a bottle from one of my old CSMs who drank it. So this is for you and Danita to keep on your shelf, and thank you. Again, you're part of the Special Forces legacy and the legacy of the United States Army. Thank you, sir. Yeah.
Larry, I can help you with that tonight.
Hey, sir. This is where iron sharpens iron. And when you're out there operating, you hear your call sign come up, you know it's you. So from the Warriors, myself.
From the Zipka family, so having worked with General Henry for a couple years as his XO, he provided a lot of opportunities and mentorship over the years. The second half, or his better half, Danita, put an immense amount of energy into the families and dedicated time individually with the wife. So from the Zipka family to the Henry family, it's going to be your first adventure. I appreciate everything you've done, sir. Thanks, Danita.
Thank you. soldiers from the sky. Fearless men who jump and die. Men who mean just what they say. The brave men of the green beret. Silver wings upon their chest. These are men, America's best. 100 men will test today. The lonely tree will bring the rain. Trained to live on nature's land. Trained in combat, hand to hand. Men who fight by night and day. Courage big on the river rain. Silver wing upon their chest. These are men, America's best. 100 men will test today. The lonely tree will greet the rain. Back at home, a young wife waits. Her green beret has met his fate. He has died for those oppressed, leaving her this last request. But silver wings on my son's chest make him one of
is a daughter and their son, being a lover to their mother, everything to everyone, up and down bright and early, my business and my suit, I'm just a poor success, from my head down to my boots. I don't do it for the money, there's bills that I can't pay. I don't do it for the glory, I just do it anyway. Providing for our futures, our responsibility. Yeah, I feel good under pressure, being all that I can be. I can't call in sick on Monday when the weekend's been too strong. I just went straight through the holidays, sometimes all night long. You can bet that I stand ready when the wolf growls at the door. Hey, I'm solid, hey, I'm steady, hey, I'm true down to the core. And I will always do my duty, no matter what the price. I've counted up the cost, I know the sacrifice. Oh, and I don't want to die for you, but if dying's asking me, I'd barely cross the border, cause freedom don't come free. I'm an American soldier, and I never can, cause I'm my brothers and my sisters, I will proudly take a stand. When liberty's in jeopardy, I will always do what's right. I'm out here on the front lines, sleeping here tonight. American soldier, American soldier.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will now hear from Brigadier General retired Larry Allen.
I promised Anita I would not make her cry today. I'm not sure why I'm nervous. I retired like 4 months ago, but she's been driving me crazy today about making things perfect. General Turner had to leave, I know. So, General Smith, Chief CRC, a retired Sergeant Major, 19th Group Command Team, the Special Forces Association, fellow soldiers, family and friends, thanks for coming out today. I gotta admit, like most of us, we don't plan on this day when we enlist, but it does arrive and sooner than you actually expect. So I enlisted on 7 July of 1987. I never aspired to any kind of a rank or position, just beyond earning a Green Beret and looking for some opportunities beyond what my 2.3 GPA from rural Ohio education.
education would provide.
Along that way, God's opened some doors, sometimes some windows, and providing opportunities for Danita and me that we could never imagine. Just a couple comments on a couple of pictures. The woman towing the tiger, she sent me into Walmart to get something. I can't remember what it was. And I was in there for a longer period of time than she expected, and she started sending me texts like, what's taking so long, what's going on? And then I came out, and I showed her the picture. I'm like, I had to stay in line to get my picture taken with Tony. And she was like, really? And I was like, Tony the Tiger's here. I'm not going to get my picture. She was not very happy with me. Of course, there's many people I'd like to thank by name, but I'm going to keep the list limited to a couple people. I don't want to take all your time today. First and foremost, I want to thank God for the opportunities, experience, and the safety he's provided by his grace over the years. I was privileged to serve for most of my 34 years in Special Forces and Airborne units during peacetime and combat. I've been exceptionally blessed to have never been significantly hurt or injured, and I'm going to qualify this statement because I think my mother's watching on the live stream, making some very calculated risks that needed to be taken during combat operations, and I still came away without a scratch. So it's all through his grace that happened. Secondly, I want to thank the most important person in my life, and that's Danita. You know, we met on a bus going to look at rocks for a geology lab when we attended Wright State University at Glen Helen State Nature Preserve in Yellow Springs, Ohio. The only reason that town is significant, maybe you may have heard of it, Chappelle lives there. Little did either of us know that that chance encounter would lead to a little over 34 plus years of us being together. I'm thankful every day for your love, your support, and your understanding in this job that we've been doing for the last 30 years. You've been a key part of our house to keep the house running, raising the boys, and most of the time without me being there. You've been there to support every training event, every deployment that I volunteered or was voluntold to go on. I love you. And like Gerald Turley said, now we can do some of the things that we want to do. So as a token of my appreciation, I just want to give you this. Served me well over the last 34 years. The understanding that hard work gets rewarded and that the freedom of opportunity provided by this country is special and rare. We didn't always have everything I wanted as a probably pretty demanding child, but we had everything we needed. And you both made sure through your example of hard work that we did not go without the things we needed. That lesson, an example of sacrifice, has not gone unnoticed. They're underappreciated. So being a soldier has been one of the things that's defined me for the last 34 years. That being said, I would offer a word of caution to my fellow service members. Remember the rule of threes. Some of you may have heard this, some of you may have not. But after you retire, in 3 days, your peers are going to go, hey, where's Joe? In three weeks, they're going to ask, where did Joe go? And in 3 months, they're going to ask, who was Joe? So my advice, put your family first before your job, because when you retire, the Army is going to replace you, probably before your seat's cold. If you haven't taken care of your family and your relationships, you're going to end up with no ties to the Army and nobody to spend your retirement with. I probably could have done a better job with this task, so if I pass on no other advice, that would be it. My retirement was official on 30 September, but due to circumstances, of course, COVID, family, and other things going on, we haven't been able to hold a ceremony until now. But I have had the opportunity to reflect on some things, and I just want to share two things with you. Number one, and I've always told everyone I counsel throughout the years, your last interaction with the Army is going to be negative. It's the Army saying, thanks for your time, but we're replacing you. Even if it's your decision when to retire, the Army's got to find a way to make it painful. I'm just going to say one word that most of you are going to know and understand why. Tricare. If the Army is nothing else, it's a bureaucracy. They take the fun out of everything. The United States Property and Fiscal Officer for Ohio is Colonel Tom Caldwell. He was in one of those pictures. We graduated ROTC together. He once told me several years ago, you have to love being a soldier despite the Army. Number two, and now that I am retired, I get to have an opinion. I'll try to keep most of it to myself. But if we lose our meritocracy in the system of how we choose leaders and how we retain people in their military, we're going to see a sharp decline in the professionalism of that same institution. After having spent 13 months with NATO and our partner nations in Europe, if we promote, assign, or retain personnel based on anything other than merit, we're going to become average military forces just like them. I don't say this lightly. Some of our partners are great partners. They're with us through thick and thin. But the United States military is the most professional and capable on the face of the planet. And if we lose that, it's going to be bad for the world. Some of these countries still promote people based on their political affiliation, their social status, their religion, their seniority, or other factors that have nothing to do with their capability. And we have not done that historically. And we need to make sure we keep that meritocracy in place. The privilege of command is not a participation trophy. No officer is entitled to command based on their seniority or how long they've waited for their turn. Only if they respect and understand the responsibility for America's greatest assets, our sons and daughters, should they be entrusted with command. That's it for the preaching. Finally, I'd like to share two thoughts of some great historic leaders that have influenced me and have been particularly appropriate for me throughout my career. I think these thoughts are relevant to most of the soldiers here and probably some of those that are watching on the live stream. Winston Churchill once said, "It's not enough that we do our best. Sometimes we have to do what's required." I know I've pushed many of you who've worked with me over the years to do things that was out of your comfort level, asking and tasking you to do things you thought weren't possible, feasible, or at times advisable. But we as professional soldiers are capable of accomplishing things way beyond what we think sometimes. There's no doubt that any of the tasks that I gave you throughout those times and years, that you were capable of achieving those things that I was asking you to do. President Kennedy, probably one of the most prominent early supporters of the fledgling Special Forces, said, "There are risks and costs to action, but they are far less than the long-range risks of comfortable inaction. Don't become comfortable, and don't become stagnant." And the last thought I'd like to share with you is from the 40th President of the United States, Ronald Reagan. My wife is going to shrug her shoulders and laugh. Just, as many of you know, I have a personal affinity towards President Reagan. He was the president when I enlisted as a private in 1987. He had re-energized the American patriotism that we so badly needed, describing America as a shining city on a hill for everybody to look to and aspire to. He was bold, and at times he took calculated risks to accomplish great things, again, usually against the advice of some of his advisors. And I think we can look at some of his examples to see what can be accomplished if we're willing to take some of those calculated risks. There's five speeches I always ask people to listen to for inspiration from President Reagan. His 1964 speech is called The Time for Choosing. His 1981 inaugural address where he lays out his vision. His 1983 speech where he referred to the Soviet Union as the evil empire. His 1988 State of the Union address and his farewell address. I'm only going to focus on his farewell address and only one aspect of his farewell address. During his speech, he talked about some of the great accomplishments of his two terms in office and how he was referred to as the great communicator. But he graciously gave credit to the people that had accomplished those things for him, and he said he was not responsible for those achievements. He once stated, "There's no limit to the amount of good you can do if you don't care who gets the credit." Over the last weeks and months, and even today, I received an email from soldiers that have worked for me or people I've worked with, thanking me for something I did for them, something I counseled them about, something I helped them with, but I want to give credit where credit is due. And I spoke with some of these influencers at my last promotion ceremony, but their impact is beyond measure. I've been privileged in 34 years, and you've seen in some of those pictures, to to serve alongside and be mentored by some great Americans. The most important are the non-commissioned officers. I can't tell you the influence these soldiers have had on my life. These guys, along the way, have coached, teached, and mentored me of what it means to be a leader in the Army of this great republic. From my detachment in B Company in Ohio, Master Sergeant retired Ed Pekovich, my former 18 Fox, Command Sergeant Major retired Randy Martin, my retired 18 Charlie, Chief Warrant Officer 2, former SAR First Class Ed Juro, my former 18 Echo, who warned me never to touch a radio, Staff Sergeant A.J. Smiley, another former 18 Charlie, Chief Warrant Officer 4, retiring former 18 Echo Rick Calloway, and Sergeant Major retired Chris Belford, my team sergeant. Here in Utah, the list is long as well. Sergeant Major retired Gary Barnes, Sergeant Major retired Steve Woolridge, Sergeant Major retired Jason Legler, Sergeant Major Joey Moromoto, Danny Bellingham, Master Sergeant Eric Huntsman, and countless others who I've counted on every day while in battalion and group. My accomplishments are only because I was able to stand on their shoulders. These non-commissioned officers taught me what it is to be a teammate, a leader, a mentor, and served as examples of what a professional soldier should know and how he should act, supporting our Army's values. Never asking anyone to do anything that they weren't willing to do themselves, up to and including putting themselves in personal harm. I want to thank every one of them for everything they've done and their inspirational example. And with that, I'm going to give you your precious time back. Thanks for coming to celebrate with Danita and me today. The oppressor be bearer, and God bless the United States.
ceremony. On behalf of General Henry and his family, thank you for attending. Please join us in extending congratulations and best wishes to General Henry and his family in front, and remain for refreshments at the rear.